Hello friends, welcome to my channel Biology with Aagam. Today we are going to discuss on a topic, the separation of protein with the help of electrophoresis. So now, before wasting time, let's start with the topic. What basically electrophoresis stands for? Electrophoresis is the moving of the charged particles in the presence of electric field. The charged particles may be of DNA or a protein. In an electrophoresis unit, I'm drawing the rough sketch of the electrophoretic unit. This is an electrophoretic unit in which there are two terminals. One is positive and the second is negative. So when we put or cast the DNA or protein in this, so the DNA, as we cast the DNA, DNA is negatively charged. So it moves from negative to positive terminal. And if a protein is casted in it, then the nature of protein defines that from which direction it have to move on. So in the electrophoretic unit, what we basically have, there is a chamber which is a transparent plastic chamber in which there is a buffer solution filled in it. A buffering solution is needed in it so that there is the maintenance of ions in it in the solution, and a gel cast is also put in it. In a gel cast is just like that. There is a gross gel or whatever. This is a matrix in which the protein or the DNA is filled. So before casting the gel in the electrophoretic unit, we just hole out wells, small wells in the electrophoretic unit, in the gel cast, and fill the material which we want to separate out, whether it is a protein or a DNA. So we are now talking about the protein, so we just talk about the protein in it. So we have to put the protein here and put this chamber just as it is here. So these are the holes. I am making it vertically, in it it's horizontally. So I am making it this side. And if the nature of the protein is positive, then it moves from the positive terminal to negative terminals. So after some time, the protein reaches there and shows the bend in it. So this different color bends, just like that. The protein moves in different sequences in the gel. Are they required? So we just have to put this gel in the electrophoretic unit chamber, which is shown just like that. I'm making it at this horizontal manner. It is in vertical manner actually. So the particles which are smaller will move slowly in the gains of charge, because it is positively charged protein. So it moves, if a small charge is present, then it moves slow, and if a bigger charge is present, then it moves faster than the smaller charge. So I'm making that these are the small charges. These are the big charges which protein particles which move faster than the smaller ones. So this is the overall principle, that the movement of charged particles in the electric field, in the presence of electric field, is the electrophoresis. The separation principle is all about that. The electrophoresis is of also four types in the separation of protein. I am only talking about the separation of protein, in the matter of separation of protein. So in the matter of separation of protein, there are four types of methods which we follow for the separation of protein. The four methods are, the first one method is, the first method is the gel cast method. Or the other method, or we can say that it's a gross method.
We will talk about these methods in detail later. Second one is the SDS gel electrophoresis. Third one is the ion exchange electrophoresis. The fourth one is immunodeficient or diffusent electrophoresis. About the first method, that is the gel cast method or the Aagam method or Aagam method. In this method, what basically happens is that we just have to take a electrophoretic unit and a gel cast, which is made up of the gel or agar or agarose gel. In which, what we basically do is that this is an electrophoretic unit and this is the gel casting agar. We just make wells in it and fill the protein sample in it for the separation. So before filling the protein, we just have to use exonuclease, an enzyme which cuts the protein into small fragments. So after firstly use exonuclease for cutting the large sequence of the protein into the smaller one. These smaller ones are filled in these wells, and then this gel cast will be put in this chamber in which the positive and negative electrodes are present, and run the electricity, which is DC in nature. There is a direct current, not the alternating current which is used in the electrophoresis, because alternating current denatures the properties of the substance which we are going to isolate. So after putting this unit there, we will see that there is a movement of these particles from here to there, here to there, and the movement is according to their size, charge, and many more important properties of them. So these movement is just like that. So this is what I am talking about, the gel cast method. In this, after the electricity passed for a particular time, the protein reaches at a specific point from their size and charges. So we will separate these proteins from the gel. That's all about the gel cast method. The second method is SDS method. It is also similar to that one, but the only difference is that in SDS, sodium dodecyl sulfate is used to denature the protein chain, means that to cut out, not denature, the denature word is not correct for that sentence, for cutting out the protein sequence in small parts so that we can fill it in the wells. The same thing that occurs in the SDS method, we just have to cast the gel in which we make the wells in which we have to put out the sample, and we have to put it in the electrophoretic unit. After the thing, the electrophoretic unit use the electricity and DC current, and we will get the protein. Only the difference is the SDS is used in this method. SDS means sodium dodecyl sulfate, which is a substance which degrade the proteins in small particles. The third one is the ion exchange electrophoresis. What is ion exchange electrophoresis? This is different from the other one. So let's talk about it. This is the ion exchange electrophoresis. Ion exchange In this, what we basically do is that there is also the similar or the same electrophoretic unit. The gel cast is also same. Just as with the gel cast is common in all methods. The gel cast is same. This is the gel cast. And what is in it? We just have put, we have made wells from both the sides. Both the sides. And in the positive terminal and in the negative terminal, we have in the electrophoretic unit, not there in the gel. There is a positive and negative terminal in this. So, before putting the, means that after putting the gel in the electrophoretic unit, we just have to oppositely fill the wells. Means that if this terminal is in the positive point, means that we are doing it here. If there is positive terminal, then we have to put out or fill the wells with the negative charge protein. And in the negative terminal, we have to fill it with the positive charge protein. So after what, after the electricity pass, what happens? There is a movement of the charged particles across each other because they are oppositely charged to each other. If the positive moves here and the negative moves here, positive to negative, negative to positive. So they make a clump like that in between, in which there is a positive charge here and a negative charge here. This type of clumping may shows that different charges of protein separated in a different manner. So we can identify that there is negative and there is positive. But in this experiment, we know that we have filled the negative and the positive sample in the gel. So this type of occurrence will appear in the ion exchange electrophoresis. So this is what about the ion exchange electrophoresis. Now come to the immunodeficient electrophoresis. What is it all about? Let's talk it about. Immunodeficient electrophoresis. This is the fourth one which we are going to talk about. In this, what basically happens, there is the antigen-antibody reactions. Antigen-antibodies are also the proteins also. We just have to find out how to separate them. So, in this electrophoresis, what is it? Immunodeficient electrophoresis. There is a precipitation line observed because of the clumping of antigen and antibody. In which what we basically do is such as the ion exchange electrophoresis, we make the wells in both the sides and fill one side with the antigen and the second side with the antibody. And after the electric field is applied, means that this is in the chamber, after the electric field is applied, they come in front, they come in between that and makes a precipitate line. They make the precipitate line which shows that they are making the clump. They are precipitated due to the antigen antibody reactions, because they are opposite in natures. So this precipitation line will be separated out, and protein will be separated or identified on the basis of this. So this is all about the four methods of electrophoresis. I hope you like the video. Thanks for watching. If you have any topic in your mind which you are problematic, then ask me in the comment box. I will definitely reply on the message and make a comfortable video for you, so that the problem will be solved for you from yourself. Thanks for watching. Subscribe the channel for more interesting videos. Thank you so much.